Hello!
Welcome to Prevention. How are you doing?
Earlier we had a beer from Carnopolis. It was their original. This one is their Pilsner. We had a few Pilsners the other day in Belenga.
Quite nice and refreshing. So
I think we had a honey one, two honey ones, didn't we?
Yeah. One of them being a really strong, pungent honey.
Yeah, I think it was more in the texture. And the flavour. It's a little golden.
It's almost like a crisp look to it, I mean.
It's not as foamy head as the original that we had earlier.
It's a bit more sweetness to the original.
Now, again, that's what's the traditional aromas you would get from a European beer. There's a slight oniness there, whereas the other one was more smooth and... This is a blue cap. Yeah, I mean, Belanger, we can't speak highly of it. Great people, and there's always a lovely selection of lagers and stuff there.
They also do lovely Polish food and that, so it's always worth a try.
I mean, I think I had the sausage, the Bratwurst sausage thing. There's a technical term for it, but sorry, term for it.
So you had a bit of Polish sausage, did you?
And it's beautiful. And Andrew says, a sausage can't be that good. And he goes, and you let the onions and everything else, and it was just everything was just real nice. And Andrew's a fan of the ham shank,
and I had a bit of schnitzel.
And this past week we had the pierogi, which is always an easy favourite for us.
That sort of folds us in anyway.
I know, we were surprised because we were so hungry when we went in, but the pierogi soon fills up,
and we sort of like combined it with the honey beer, and it was sort of went really well.
Yeah.
This Pilsner is quite light and refreshing. There's a bit of a little bit of bite to it.
It's got a little bit more maltiness there, more biscuity.
Yeah.
It's not. I don't think it's as smooth, but is that because that only texture?
I mean, like you said, it was had a darker tinge to the original.
Yeah.
So yeah, but it does come off like a bit more biscuity, sweeter.
And what I love about this is they're taking a trait from some of the British brewers, or some of the brewers actually do this, and they put what you see, what you smell, and what you taste. So you can actually, even if you don't know Lithuanian, you can actually learn some Lithuanian just by drinking beer.
So what's it saying?
From the rum, the look, I'm getting a Yipak and a Skandras, and on the aroma I'm getting... Guntamas and Sally Kalas. And from the taste I'm getting, no.
What?
I'm definitely getting Lengifas. Maybe a bit of Mazi. Or maybe a bit of Katus. No offense. I think they're all pasteurised. I mean, they have to travel a lot around the world, don't they? So we're lucky that a lot of the European shops stock such a varied range of...
That has a more of a sweet aroma. More like you said, honey.
Yeah. I think because of the transit, some of the flavours... Sit more to the bottom, and some are really pronounced syrupy on the aroma sometimes.
Yeah.
But I do like that one. As with the other one, it's got like nice smoothness there, but this has got a little more bite to it.
It's got a... With the aggressive pour, you've got more of the slight lemon bite to it with a nice sweet biscuit taste.
I think because a lot of them just sit there on the shelves a lot of times, it just gradually goes to the bottom. So it's always good to shake a bottle. I mean, as we always do, don't we? It was like shit. Sometimes it gets out of our hands, literally.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, two for two so far. Definitely check out these. If they're in your nearest shop or bar, you take care.